Hi, I'm not Trickelic Phillips, but I'll teach you some things about the Source Engine. Tactical Intervention is a game by Minley, also named Guzman, one of the two co-creators of the original Counter-Strike. The game was released in 2013. Many ideas from the Counter-Strike betas were reused, like using the hostages as shield as terrorists, VIP mode, and cars. It also featured new ideas, like dogs. Cute little dog. Sit. The game was a free-to-play model, but it didn't achieve having enough players. After years of struggling with independent developers, the servers definitely were shut down in 2017. As you already guessed, Tactical Intervention uses the Source Engine. I really loved the Milano map, and I wanted to port it to CSGO. I guess it reminds me when I visited the city, back in 2015. I was a bit concerned at the beginning, because a lot of modifications has been done to the engine, so maybe it wouldn't work, but I've seen some ports on Garry's mod, so I was confident. First task was to decompile the map. I used the famous BSP source for it, and guess what? It even have a tactical intervention option. The decompile went kinda well, but as I expected, I ran into lots of strange things and errors. After cleaning up a bit, I tried to copy all the materials into the folders, but I ran into that shader error. Strange. After searching, it turned out some glasses material were the cause. Never mind, I use the default CSGO glass materials. So the basic map launched, that was the good news. But now I needed to get the models working. As I had some errors putting all the models, at first I decided to recompile every model. But in the end, it wasn't necessary. Guess I could have saved some more time here. The main problem is that I had a lot of models missing. And that's because I'm using this old extracted package that Guzman himself gave me the link. Milan was one of the latest map released, so I assume some models weren't ready yet. By the way, if someone knows how to extract those FBX files or whatever, leave me a comment under the video. So, because the error message when a model is missing is huge, I had to do it step by step. Step 1, search a model through the entity report. Step 2, click go to. Step 3, group and put every model in a new vis group. Step 4, disable all props. Step 5, reactivate the models through the vis group I created. Step 6, test the map. In the end, I did it by batch. It was much faster. So I use vis group to regroup every folder. Much, much faster. Still, some models cause a failed compilation. For example, this stone model. I finally had to change it from prop static to prop dynamic to make it work. So I ran through a stupid number of testing over and over. Also, I rapidly noticed some models had to be scaled. I don't know how it was done with tactical intervention, but with the introduction of prop resize in CSGO, it was an easy fix. Thanks, Valve. I also had to add some solid for the missing models sometimes. Quick and dirty fix. Also, I could remove specific tactical inversion entities, like this rappel point entity. So I test. And finally, I run into a decent result. You can grab the actual state of the map in the workshop. Remember, it's an alpha. Don't forget to thank Guzman and all tactical inversion developers. I even heard rumors they may release the game at some point. I hope you liked this video and that you learn some stuff. Also, check my other maps. I'm a big GoldenEye and Perfect Dark fan.